Hey there, Matt again for the My Learning Channel. A little while ago I made a tutorial showing you how to rig a character in just a few minutes using Maya's Quick Rig feature. While it produces great rigs for simple background characters or mobile games, many of you have asked how to add finger or toe controls in order to expand its use to hero characters in bigger productions. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to start with a finished Quick Rig, which I already showed you how to build in that previous tutorial. Click the link on your screen or in the description below if you need a refresher on that. As per that video, notice that I've painted skin weights to get nice deformations when moving my controls around. The first thing I'll do is back these up, since it'd be a pain to have to redo them. So I'll select my mesh and, in the rigging menu set, go to Skin, Export Weight Maps. In the options, I'm going to increase the resolution a bit. This is a pretty simple model, but the extra fidelity will just ensure I capture the results accurately. 512 by 512 should do. I'll name this skin weight map Ogre Body Weights. Maya will then warn me that 22 skin maps will be written out, and I'll just hit yes. So if I go to the actual folder where my scene file is, you can see that Maya has written out a bunch of .iff files. Each of these is just a snapshot of my skin weights on a joint-by-joint basis. Then the .weightmap file tells Maya how to put them back on the mesh. So now that that's backed up, the next step is to make some finger joints. Unfortunately, this isn't something supported by the auto-rig feature, so instead, I'm going to use the Create Joint tool in the rigging shelf to create them manually. Before that though, I'm just going to double-click the joint icon here to open its options. And turn on Projected Centering. Now if I click on the mesh, Maya creates a joint inside the hand. And if I keep clicking down the thumb, I get a joint chain. Once I'm done, I'll press Enter to complete it. As you can see, the projected centering has done a pretty good job of centering my joints in the thumb. However, if you want to tweak any of them, you can select it with the Move tool and then enter Pivot Mode by pressing Insert. Once I'm done tweaking, I can press Insert again to exit Pivot Mode. And finally, I'll rename these joints appropriately. Then I'll repeat this process to create joint chains for each of the other fingers as well. And then once I have individual joint chains for each of the fingers, I can mirror them over to the other side using the skeleton mirror joints command. Using the YZ axis and renaming every instance of left to right instead. So now that we've got our finger joints, it's time to incorporate them into our rig. To do this, we're going to make use of the HumanIK editor, which you can find up here. HumanIK is an easy-to-use, full-body rigging solution that's compatible with other Autodesk products like Maya, Motion Builder, and 3ds Max converted to CAD, as well as non-Autodesk products like Unity. In the Controls tab here, each of these circular buttons in the HIK editor corresponds to a control in my rig. This makes it easy to select controllers, even when they might be difficult to select in the viewport, like if they're obscured or overlapped by another object. Similarly, the Definitions tab is where I can see all the joints being controlled by these controllers. Remember, all rigs, HumanIK or other, are split into two layers, an underlying skeleton attached to the skin, much like a real skeleton, with a layer of controls on top of it to control the skeleton's bones. By default, HumanIK hides the bones, since you shouldn't touch them directly once your controls are in place. But I can forcibly display them by clicking the skeleton button here. As expected, if I drill down into the hand definition, no skeleton is defined yet. That makes sense, since I just created the joints for them. So in order to get these new finger joints into the definition, I'm first going to have to unlock the definition. This is going to delete my control rig temporarily, but don't worry, that's easy to get back. Now that my character definition is unlocked, I'm going to work these new finger joints into my skeleton. First, in the outliner, I'm going to select the top level of each one and then middle drag them onto the hand to connect them to the rest of the skeleton in the proper place. And I'll also do the same for the right side. Now I can go into the hand definition and double-click any joint here, then click the corresponding joint on my rig. And now it's turned green, showing me that it's defined. Except notice that this is actually on the right hand. That's because we have mirror matching turned on, which allowed Maya to automatically assign the opposite joint, thanks to the way we named them. However, you may or may not like the way that the editor jumps back and forth when this is enabled, so it's up to you whether to leave it on or not. Personally, I find it easy enough to just do one side. And then the other. Once everything is green, I can lock the definition back up and click this button here to regenerate my controls. And now you can see I have finger controls. However, even though I have the controls, you'll notice that they aren't actually moving the model's fingers. That's because I never skinned those joints either. So let's unbind the skin and then rebind it with these joints included. I could do this via the Skin Unbind Skin menu, but notice that returns the mesh back to its old A stance position, which would mean I'd need to line up all these controls again. Instead, I'm going to undo all that and go to Edit, Delete by Type, History. This will remove everything currently feeding my skinned mesh, including the controls and joint connections, and bake all of that into the mesh itself. In other words, not only will it unbind my skin, but also freeze the geometry in this position at the same time. Then I can just select my root hip joint and my mesh and skin it again using Skinned Bind Skin. I recommend geodesic voxel binding using dual quaternions for the best results. A resolution of 512 is a good idea too. And once I do that, the fingers get included in the skinning. We're almost done. There's just one last thing to fix. While the fingers are now included, notice how I lost all the other nice skin weights that I had worked so hard on before. But wait, I backed up those old skin weights for just such an occasion. So I'll just import those weights onto my skin and ta-da! Everything is great again. Except now my fingers don't work again. That's right. This weight map doesn't have any weights for the fingers because the joints didn't exist back then. Now, at this point, I could start from scratch and repaint these weights by hand, but I would really prefer not to do that. So let me show you a little trick to make this way easier. I'm going to undo back to just before I imported my old skin weights, when the default skin weights included my fingers. Then I'm going to export these weights as a new file named Ogre Finger Weights. Now I'm going to steal just the finger weights and merge them into my original body weights file. So in your project folder, first copy the various finger IFF files from the finger weights folder over to the body weights folder. Make sure that you get the left and right hand as well, since they're also impacted by the finger weights. Then open the finger and body weight map files in any text editor and put them side by side. In here, you'll find a very simple legend associating each joint with an IFF file. So all we need to do is copy over the hand and finger portions from one to the other. Then I'll save my body file and go back to Maya. And if I try importing that weight map again, This time you'll see it includes both my finger weights, as well as my old custom body weights. And now your character is ready for animation. Note that you can use this exact same technique to do the toes as well. Remember, if you found this tutorial useful, consider giving it a like and subscribe down below. And for even more in-depth rigging workflows, check out the rigging playlist on the Maya Learning channel.